Whether you're a seasoned Scrum Master, Agile Coach, or you're just starting out, learning should be continuous. I read your emails, I see your comments. Coach, what books do you recommend reading? So in today's video, I will share my list of top Agile books to read in 2023. This list is not in any particular order, just 13 good books to read in 2023 if you want to become a better Scrum Master, increase your skills, increase your knowledge, competencies as a Scrum Master, as an Agile Coach. Starting with Lean Startup by Eric Ries, literally one of the first Agile books I read. I read that back in 2015, mind blown by the idea of increments, releasing in increments. You'll learn the principles of Lean Startup, the Lean methodology, and why you need to release in increments instead of, you remember the old approach, working on requirements for months, building requirements, writing documentation, and then developing coding for months, for years, and releasing everything in one go and realizing that your customers don't even want that. This book will help you understand your customers, how to analyze and research the demand, the market, so that you can release in small increments. Build something early, quickly, put it to the market, get feedback, and then improve on that. Let the customers tell you what they want, and then build that quickly, not for months, but only a few days, a few weeks, you release it. That's the incremental approach. It's not really an Agile book, but talks about the core of agility. Next, Agile Project Management for Dummies. Really a good book to start your Agile journey. Talking about the values, the principles, the tools, the practices, everything you need to have, every tool you need to have, every knowledge, every skill you need to build to start your journey towards business agility. A really good book to start. Next, The Agile Enterprise by Mario E., which focuses on two things that need to happen in an organization for them to get the full benefits of agility. First one, everyone in the organization really needs to focus on delivering quality products. We need to understand that at every level in the organization. And second, all the employees need to be motivated, driven, really want to build quality products, should be empowered, make decisions within a team, not a manager somewhere telling them what to do, to be self-managed, self-organized. I really like the part about feedback loops, Agile, budgeting, Lean, Canvas, user story mapping, so many tools, everything that you need in order to build your toolkit so that you can start your Agile journey and start working with teams, transforming your organization. Again, a really good book to start. Next is Scrum Mastery, the first ever book I read about the Scrum framework. Obviously, I had read the Scrum guide, but it doesn't count. It's simply a guide. This was the first book, and it's all about how to be the greatest Scrum Master, what qualities you need, what skills you need, what knowledge, how to run all the Scrum events, how to engage with your team, how to make your team improve, how to guide your team, how to coach your team. What I really like about the book are the stories. The stories, you get to feel how a Scrum Master feels, even if you're not doing the role, through the stories, through the practical advice. Next is The Art of Agile Development, which I don't feel should be the first book you ever read in your Agile journey. Start with The Agile for Dummies, and then once you start applying agility to your organizations, to your teams, you read this book, which really talks about how to improve. You're already applying the practices, the tools, the mindset, but how to improve on that, how to reduce development costs, how to do Agile planning correctly, Agile budgeting, estimation correctly, how to apply Lean, DevOps, Scrum, the other frameworks. It's a really good book to take your Agile practices, your Agile journey to the next level and really focus on building quality products for the customer at a lower cost. Next, Founders at Work, not your typical Agile book, but a collection of interviews of well-known tech company founders at an early stage when they were just starting out, their successes, their failures, and their learning, their challenges, how they build their empire. inspire so that you can take this experience and apply that to your team, to the organization. Know how they think at the time. How are they thinking now? Really get in their mind. It's a really good book if you like the interview style and really want to change your mindset. Because all these people have one thing in common. They were focusing on the customers, and this is somewhere that you want to go. Next is Scrum, the art of doing twice the work in half the time. Really good title. And the premise of the Scrum framework from one of the founders of the Scrum framework, Geoff Sutherland, he tells his stories. The second book I read about the Scrum framework, really good book. Same as Scrum Master, refocusing on the role of a Scrum Master. This one focuses on the Scrum framework. You'll learn from reading the stories of Geoff how he implemented Scrum 20 years ago and how it's still relevant now. Next is Agile estimating and planning. One of the hardest things to do in software development is actually planning, especially if you have a lot of Agile teams working together, dependent on each one another. Planning is hard. Read this book if you want to get better at estimating and planning. Highly recommended. Next, Essential Scrum. While all the other books that we talked about earlier about the Scrum framework, the target was the Scrum Master, the Agile Coach. If you want to be a good Scrum Master and Agile Coach, read these books. But this one is for the tech leads, the managers, the project managers, people who don't really help teams implement the Scrum framework, but they also need to understand the Agile principles, the Agile values, the Scrum framework, how the Scrum framework will help them, and what's their role in implementing and using the Scrum framework. The next book, Agile Retrospectives. If you have at least one Agile team in your organization, I don't really care if you're using Scrum or just a Kanban board, please do retrospectives at least once every 2 weeks. Continuous improvement, extremely important. And retrospectives is an amazing tool for continuous improvement. If you do it well, read the book. Next is The Deadline, a really good book. Not your typical Agile book. It's written like a novel, but I enjoyed it a lot. Follows Mr. Tompkins, a fictional character who has a company with an impossible deadline. How will he do it? Will he fail? Will he succeed? I won't spoil it for you. Read it. Next is Agile Project Management with Kanban. Kanban is something that you can use with your teams, in your organization, in your personal life. And that's a really good book if you're starting out with Kanban. It's been on the bestsellers list, Amazon's bestsellers list for years. Read the book. And last but not least, coaching Agile teams. If you want to be a good Agile coach or even a good Scrum Master, learn how to mentor, how to coach people, how to be a good teacher, how to increase the performance, the efficiency, the productivity, how to guide people to do all these things. Read the book. Which brings me to my next point. If you want more tips, insights on Agile, Scrum, personal growth, click on the video that stands out the most on the screen right now. And I'll see you in a few seconds.